I have tales to tell that are difficult to believe, for sure. But somebody's got to tell them. And, you know, that's what I do. And, of course, it gets back to be like, wow, that's crazy. You know, nobody believes this. And eventually that wears on you. Eventually it does. So I'm trying to continue to keep on here. Because the closer we get to truth, the greater distance that the narrative is from what we're used to, from what culture accepts as normal. This is the trouble, isn't it? And but when we hear these tales and narratives, at least we get used to them. At least we get used to them, and a little bit of it filters in, and we say, well, how much of this can I accept based on I want to seem to fit in and to the narrative of the world, this world. And so we tend to push away the rest of the stuff. But I've spent my life listening to narratives that are just... That's the world, the squirrely world, chastising me for speaking up. But because I've listened to narratives from others so much in my life, and respected that so much of what they've done, I want to continue payback that you know, out of gratitude for everyone's helped me to continue the tradition of speaking truth in this place that is dedicated to deception. It's really dedicated to trying to get rid of guilt, and all the myriads of ways. We have this vast tapestry of efforts and pathways. Now, what I saw last night and this morning working on this was that I believe I'm trying to enslave myself. I'm trying to turn my body into a slave who will just take care of all the menial work somehow for spirit. And then that will remove the guilt from spirit. The spirit will say, oh, look, there's no residue, there's no troubles. I have something along those lines. You think that's crazy. You know, what? But in looking at it, and listening to the teachings of Jesus last night in A Course in Miracles, somehow, you know, I see that this is a possibility, how we can set ourselves up, our life, to try and split our mind, as it were, and turn the body into a slave. We're trying to turn the body into a slave. This is how I see it. It's very amazing. But the body doesn't have a mind. So we're actually trying to split our mind and have part of our mind act as if it were the body, and have the body just be like a slave to take care of all the menial tasks, whereas and then spirit sits there and says, ah, look how creative I am, and then hopes it gets rid of the guilt that way. And so I was willing to entertain the possibility that this is possible, and then therefore it would not be everybody else, you know, my misfortune in the world, that the problem is I'm trying to bring the misfortune on myself, to turn the body into this complete lowly slave to get rid of guilt. It's all based on trying to get rid of guilt. So that way, this is in line with what Jesus teaches, that everything we have done, we set up our own circumstances for our own purposes. But this goes a little step further in talking about slavery and trying to enslave ourselves, our bodies. Of course, when you write a book, you can't include everything because the book would be endless because of the tapestry of what everyone's doing. So, you know, she points out the basic parameters, then we have to apply it to our lives and try to be honest and try to see. I also saw in a dream, how I suddenly leapt over this gap and slipped underneath a barrier and got past it with a flourish. And it's like, wow, I did it. And I looked at the barrier, there's a barricade, like, you know, you barricade streets off. And there was all these sawhorses and planks and stuff sort of haphazardly put up there to try to create a barrier. And somehow, an aspect of myself which is very supple and coordinated made this sudden leap and slid underneath and then popped up underneath and said, aha, did it, look at that. Got past the block, the blockage, the barricade. So I'm feeling very sick still. But it could be that this is simply the strain of letting go of delusion, that somehow it causes such a fear that you have this dip like this. Is this possible? Because I'm really still shaking in fear. There's something really fearful that is bothering me. I believe it is this sort of leap over this seeming trench or gap or something that is like, you know, you're just sort of like too nervous about it. And suddenly I saw myself doing it. Now, it is inferred and implied and even stated a bit in Jesus' teachings that there has to be at some point sort of a leap of faith. And this is what I've been working on. And this is what is... We need to do this, let's put it that way. We need to do it. And certainly we won't do it if we don't pay any attention to doing it. That is for sure. So however it feels or seems like, oh, you know, we have to do that. Yeah, we have to do that. We do have to make this leap. And the way to do it is to, as I have said, to say, I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened. So I worked on this for hours and hours this morning. Made a lot of headway. And no big breakthroughs or anything like that. But that's okay. It's setting the stage for a leap past the final barricade. You know, and I looked at the barricade. It was nothing big deal at all. It was just really a slipshod. You can easily get past it, actually. But it's doing it that you don't realize you can do it until you actually do it. Then you say, wow, that wasn't so difficult at all. So it's to practice placing yourself already. I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened. Is it possible to practice this? Yes. Again, hours and hours and hours this morning. I was practicing and practicing and spinning off all sorts of different variations of this. And as the day comes, I get up and move around, it sort of fades away, the ability fades a little bit. But I can go back to the basic, I am already enlightened. So, the parameters I would say is that there is this kind of, what I saw was, it was like two streets joined together, but they weren't really joined well, and the joining was all confusing, very confusing. And it seems like you can't find a way to step through it. This is how it feels. And so you need to leap over it. And then we put this barricade to try to discourage us from leaping over it. If the barricade wasn't there, it would be easy to leap over it, but it seems like it's difficult because of that barricade, because if you leap, you're going to hit the barricade. So what I did was I leapt and I kind of somehow, you know, crouched down as I leapt and sort of slid underneath the barricade and then popped up at the other, behind the barricade and said, did it. So there is a very sort of an artful way, there's a way to do it, but this fear grips us. I've been in the grips of this fear now for almost 20 days. It's been actually now, yeah. And it doesn't seem to want to leave. So I have to keep working on this. So, one, again, is it possible to practice? Yes, it is. Is it going to be possible? It would be possible for someone to help out. Yes, it is. Once we, you know, get the full confidence in this, it is possible to help others. Say, try this. Say this. Say this. Say this. Come on. You know, keep practicing. Absolutely, it is. No question about it. I went through it enough this morning to know it is very easily doable. If we're patient enough with our situation, realizing that there is this final barricade fear situation that can make us seem like wow, I don't think I can succeed. I think I'm going to fail. This kind of thing. There needs to be this leap. The leap is to say, I am already enlightened. Feeling that the difficulty of this in comparison with regular normal day living and belief systems and stuff like that, it's hard to get any depth to it. But this morning, early in the morning, lay in bed, I was able to get great depth in practice with it. So it's just this little familiarity issue that we need to gradually roll it out here, gradually roll it out. Start getting gradually used to it. So, I believe I'll make the leap. I do. I was able to, in my mind, easily get comfortable with the notion that no body, no world, no guilt. I am already sharing the vision of timelessness. I'm already sharing the vision of timelessness. No body, no world, no guilt. See, no body, no world, no guilt. I'm already sharing the vision of timelessness. No body, no world, no guilt. Now, can we? And the answer is yes. And in fact, there's no more answers. I've already succeeded. See, this is what we need to get into. I've already succeeded. I'm already sharing the vision of oneness. I'm already sharing the vision of timelessness. I'm already enlightened. I'm already perfect. I'm already complete. I'm already in the oneness. I'm already abiding. I'm already in the light. I'm already joyous. I'm already love. I'm already peace. So there isn't any can we. See, we drop that. I've already done it. What do you mean can't? Can I do it? No, I've already done it. This is the leap. Okay. And at some point, what Jesus says and what I'm experiencing directly is there needs to be this sort of this leap of faith and trust that, you know, success is inevitable for you. And since it's inevitable, I've already succeeded. I've already succeeded since it's... How can I not be what I already am? I already am what I am. I'm already truth. I'm already pure. I'm already clean. I'm already forgiven. I'm already guilt-free. I'm already guilt-free. No body, no world, no guilt. No time, no process, no guilt. I'm already seeing perfection. I'm already stable. I'm already serene. I'm already calm. I'm already feeling the calmness. There's no question, can I? I've already done it. So we need to see ourselves now as having already done it, having already succeeded. This is the trick. This is the leap. See, the ego keeps telling us we got to keep stepping. No, we don't. We can take a leap, actually. We can leap across this little area of confusion. Actually, the entire world, the universe, is nothing but leverage. I had a dream a while ago that showed this, that I want to make a deal to get well here. And someone said, okay, we can get you well, but we can't promise that it's going to stay that way, because you can't really promise anything in this situation, in this universe, in this belief system. And then I saw that everyone is leveraged. Everything is leveraged. Nothing is stable. Nothing is certain. This is the way things are. And then I realized that everyone is leveraged. They pretend that maybe they've got it all together and they're secure and everything, but no. Those that they're relying upon are also leveraged, and on and on. And it's just one vast, constantly shifting, changing, leveraged situation here. Can't rely upon this at all. So, in trying to figure out any situation, the fact is, there isn't any situation or circumstance, because it's infinitely leveraged along with everything else. It's just one ball of leverage. And so you're looking at this, trying to figure out, how do I step here, how can I be certain, you cannot. So this leap, as you leap over it, you're saying, this doesn't matter. I don't need to figure anything out. I already know that I've succeeded. Success is already a given. And that is true. It's like somebody sleeping. You get some point in the dream, you realize that waking up is already a given. There's already a given. So why don't I just start to realize that I'm already awake? I'm already awake. This is how we wake up from the dream, is not to struggle with the dream. Say, what do I need to do next in this dream? What do I need to do next? What's the next step? Shift, take a leap and say, hey, I'm already awake. And keep repeating to yourself, I'm already awake. And when any of the dreams starts to come back in your mind, say, no, too late, I'm already awake. It's too late for the dream. I don't need to respond to the dream at all. I'm already awake. This is this leap, this little leap that we use our mind and concepts and imagination like this. Jesus said, imagine that you're already joyful and already, you know, saved and already forgiven. Imagine how it feels to already be this way. This is the trick. This is the leap. If we realize that this whole dream is just an attempt to get rid of guilt, and a dream like what we're dreaming can never get rid of the guilt, only waking from the dream and realizing we are the dreamer of the dream. And that we realize we don't need to dream. That gets rid of the guilt. that gets rid of the guilt, so to speak. And there may be some what Jesus says, beautiful designs or something, a flowing light that we see. That's what he says, so I trust in that. But the overall parameters are that we can have the guilt drop away, but not as long as we are trying to get rid of it through some technique or something. That is the guilt. The belief in process is the guilt. Okay, so that's why I say I'm already awake. And this people say, what's the process? Nope, no process. I'm already awake. You're not focusing on process. Well, how? No, it's too late for how. I am awake. I'm already awake. I'm already enlightened. I'm already perfect. I'm already complete. I'm already one. Already I am. Already in the isness. I'm already stable. I'm already certain. I'm already free. I'm already free. No process to it. I'm already free. There goes the guilt, right? No more guilt because... because it's the belief in process that brings a feeling of guilt. So here we are trying to figure out, how do we climb out of this pit? And we say, no, I'm already out of the pit. I'm already out of the pit. Take that stance. And there seems to be a gap. Well, you were here in the pit, and now you say you're out. Well, how do... I'm too late for that. I'm already out. I'm already out. Do not let your mind be pulled back into process. Okay, because the guilt will be there then, and then you will keep, that will keep feeding the feeling like you need to find some process that will work. But no process works. So I'm already free of process. I'm already sharing the vision of oneness. No body, no world, no guilt. I'm already sharing the vision of oneness. And someone says, well, how do you say, too late, I'm already sharing the vision of oneness. I'm already guilt-free, so I don't need any explanation or process. See? I don't need to get rid of guilt. I'm already free of it. I don't need to get rid of guilt. I'm already free of it. So this is the final leap, where you simply envision and imagine and use your will to assert that you're already free. And that's all there is to it. I'm already free. I'm already free. I'm already awake. I am already awake. I am already free. And then full stop in that. So we're bringing this practice of the full stop in the wow, bringing that together with this leap here. So I am already free. Wow. Now, it's quite possible that all the teachings are trying to bring us to this point, which is why these teachings always seem incomplete, don't they? Because you're trying to figure out, well, what's the process? I mean, what are all the steps? I can't quite understand. And it may be very much so that it's necessary then to take this sudden leap. Not a big leap, it's a quick little leap. That you're already free. I'm already free. The leap of realizing I'm already free. I'm already awake. And you drop all of the thinking and the processing and the steps and what did I do, how did I... You drop all that. This is not important because I'm already free. And you might say, well, it's important for somebody else. So you need to know, because they have to be brought to the same leap also. So the real emphasis on teaching is to guide and inspire to others to get to that point where they can take the leap too. The leap is not a leap out of anything. It's not a leap out of anything. It's the leap is to accept that you're already. I already leapt into freedom. That is the leap, because you're no longer using process. It's just pure assertion of this is what I am. I've said, this is something that we need to, that needs to be focused on. If we can correlate the guilt and our attempts to get rid of the guilt, realizing that all the attempts of process just keep hold on to the guilt, because what we are is totally process-free, time-free, process-free, form-free, space-free, process-free, indeterminate, spontaneous. One moment does not determine the next. Are the next, or the next, or the next, or the next. Every moment we're completely free. So to claim that we have to get to what we are through some process is to feel guilt, feel that we're not functioning in a free way, right? We're somehow less, we're functioning less than we are supposed to be functioning. And that's guilt. We feel this feeling that we don't like this feeling. It's a feeling of guilt. Like we're letting ourselves down. And yet when we try to fix it through process, that just holds on to it. Because no, okay, this, and then I have to do the next, because so this is the step, then this step leads to this step, and this step leads to this step. At some point you reach your realization that there's still this barrier. Guilt is still there. So we have to realize, I'm already here. I didn't get here. I'm already here. And see, time has to be taken out of the picture. I'm already here. Trust that has the absence of guilt with attached to it, and therefore we won't need to explain how we got here as a precursor to going further. You see, we don't need that. So I'm already here. No time involved, and thus no guilt involved, and thus we feel comfortable with that. We're at peace with that. I'm already at peace. So in practicing this morning, I was able to do it very strongly, and I could feel, you know, it's profound. I could feel it's profound. So very, very, very helpful situation now. See, we have been believing that there's some process that's going to get rid of guilt. Just the opposite. No process will ever get rid of guilt. Process is guilt. Process is guilt. And so we feel like, I have to understand the process. And so this part of us are saying, no, I can't do this. I need to understand the process. There's no process. I'm already free. It's like someone feeling they got out of this big pit, but they realize, look, and say, wait, there never was a pit. I was hallucinating. I never got out of the pit. I was never in it. But there seems to be this fear, this layer of fear, where we need to practice it it's easy to just glibly say that, but I'm finding that there's this barrier here that we need to make this little leap, which means we have to consciously practice this. I'm already free. I'm already home. I'm already home. And then full stop that. Okay, so again, this practice we've been doing, full stop in the wow, is very, very important and helpful. Because if we've been doing this, we're able to use this now and just say, just full stop, I'm already home. Full stop in the wow. No thinking, I'm already home. See, we think without process that we can point to, or somehow we're going to be just in a terrible state of guilt. Just the opposite. It's the process, belief in process is the guilt. And when we full stop, I'm already home, and that's it. There should be no guilt there. And there may be a corollary of how we view nature along with that, which is what Jesus says, that you begin to some light episodes and whatever. But what I'm focused on is this leap right now as paramount importance of a process where you set the idea of process down. I'm already home. And we'll leave thee, well, I never left home. That automatic, let that come on its own. But I'm seeing that there's this more visceral situation here of needing to say, I'm already home. I'm already home. And just rest in that one moment. Okay. So I would advise practicing. I know it's extremely challenging to do that, but either do it or you don't. Is how it works out. So we can practice right now. Some it's very easy to say, I'm already real. I am already real. I am already real. Full stop. Wow. No time involved, no process, no thinking. I'm already real. I am already one. I am already one. I am already complete. I am already complete. I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened. I am already true. I am already true. I am already free. I am already free. I am already here. I am already here. I am already now. I am already now. I am already perfect. I am already perfect. I am already blissful. I am already blissful. I am already still. I am already still. I am already peaceful. I am already peaceful. I am already awake. I am already awake. I am already divine. I am already divine. I am already divine. I am already spirit. I am already spirit. I am already God. I am already God. I am already protected. I am already protected. I am already secure. I am already secure. I am already liberated. I am already liberated. I am already saved. I am already saved. I am already holy. I am already holy. I am already sanctified. I am already sanctified. I am already the allness. I am already allness. I am already certain. I am already certain. I am already prepared. I am already prepared. I am already the ultimate. I am already the ultimate. I am already timeless. I am already timeless. I am already worthy. I am already worthy. I am already adequate. I am already adequate. I am already effortless. I am already effortless. I am already grateful. I'm already grateful. I'm already love. I am already love. I am already beneficent. I am already beneficent. I am already joyous. I am already joyous. I am already clear. I am already clear. I am already clean. I am already clean. I am already well. I am already well. I am already immaculate. I am already immaculate. I am already light. I am already light. I am already awareness. I am already awareness. I am already forgiven. I am already forgiven. I am already heaven. I am already heaven. I am already paradise. I am already paradise. I am already transcendent. I am already transcendent. I am already pure. I am already pure. I am already guilt-free. I am already guilt-free. I am already released. I am already released. I am already unlimited. I am already unlimited. I am already meaningful. I am already meaningful. I am already shared. I am already shared. I am already expanded. I am already expanded. I am already visionary. I am already visionary. I am already being. I am already being. I am already isness. I am already isness. I am already singular. I am already singular. I am already sovereign. I am already sovereign. I am already all-powerful. I am already all-powerful. I am already accomplished. I am already accomplished. I am already absolute. I am already absolute. I am already transformed. I am already transformed. I am already innocent. I am already innocent. I am already everywhere. I am already everywhere. I am already every wind. I am already every wind. I am already feeling. I am already feeling. I am already experiencing. I am already experiencing. I am already creative. I am already creative. I am already essence. I am already essence. I am already abiding. I am already abiding. I am already the self, the one self. I am already the one self. I am already carefree. I am already carefree. I am already guided. I am already guided. I am already delightful. I am already delightful. Are delighted. I'm already delighted. I am already calm. I am already calm. I am already great. I am already great. I am already seeing. I am already seeing. I'm already harmonious. I'm already harmonious. I am already formless. I am already formless. I am already natural. I am already natural. I am already steady. I am already steady. I am already stable. I am already stable. And I am already inclusive. I am already inclusive and included as one. I am already free. I am already timeless. So it's a funny thing. As we practice and prepare, it's like preparing to realize I'm already finished. I'm already finished. So it may seem like, well, wait a minute. But if you start thinking too much, then it'll sink your ship for sure. Just say, I'm already finished. I'm already home. Already complete. It's already done. It's already done. It's already over. It's already finished. It's like waking up from a dream. Now, how did I wake up? How did I? I'm not really sure. You know, I'm awake. Okay. So you don't really remember how the dream ends, do you? When you wake up, it just all sort of gets fuzzy. And if you're thinking like, oh wait a minute, I can't wake up until this dream comes to an end in a clear way. I have to see exactly. Then you'll go right back to sleep. So we have to reach a point where it doesn't matter how the dream ends, or because I'm already awake. The dream ended. This is how it ended. I'm awake. This is it. I'm already it. I'm already it. So this is a new way of conceptualizing ourselves, of seeing ourselves, of new expectations, is I'm already it. I'm already it. So all the stuff, well, how do I get to be it? How do I... It's irrelevant at this point. I'm already it. So we can train ourselves to, in this way. And in so doing, we do take the so-called leap. Or another way to put it is we become extremely right. I saw in dreams the only way to succeed is to be extremely right. And to be extremely right is to say, I'm already it. Process-free. I already am guilt-free. Now I have to say, I already have no need to say, I already have no needs. I already am need-free. I already am carefree. I already am explanation free. If you do a retrospective of your life in the spiritual path, you will realize that this is it's something that may have been sort of inferred along the way here and there, but we're getting to it now directly. As practice like this, we're always told that that's, if you just, you know, do something right, there'll be some sort of breakthrough or whatever, and you shift your perspective. Okay, fine, that's good, but we are actually practicing now this. I'm already succeeded. I've already succeeded. Succeeded. I've already succeeded at this practice. I've already finished. I'm already done. I'm already home. I'm already secure. Already enlightened. I already jumped. I already left. You know, we say, oh yeah, I've got leaving on my mind. I'm going to leave. I already left. I already left illusion. This is the leap. I've already left. I already left. We'd say, well, can we really do this? I already did it. I already did it. say that this is mature practicing, is that goes without saying, right? Because you get most people, well, those who are still trying to work out guilt, will say, wait a minute, now I got a long road, a long path I've got to, now I've already finished. And just to say that I've already finished, they say, well, but you know, no, I've got all these issues I need to solve, and, you know, which really means I have all these dreams I need to make, you know, keep dreaming. So to come across a situation where everybody's just saying, I'm already there. I've already done. I've already finished. I've already arrived. I've already finished. It's already completed. It's already done. I'm already successful. Usually this is not even thought about. It only came about because I'm so desperate and realizing that the time constraints we have as far as time worshiping in this world is so extreme. I said, we need results. I already got results. I already have the results. There's another one we can use. I already have the results. I already have the results. This is the end of time worshiping. I already have the results. I'm already free of time worshiping. So there's definitely a divide that will take place in this world between those who practice in this way and those who practice in the old way, which has time worshiping at its core. So we've been moving in this direction. The proof that we've been moving in this direction is the fact that we're already here. I'm already here. I already have the results. I'm already finished. It's already been completed. It's already done. It's already perfect. The fact that we're able to do this means that that our preparation has been well done, you know. It's been a good preparation, effective preparation. This practice, a full stop in the wow, the ability to just let it be, this enables this final, you know, this, I've already done, I'm already finished. It's already been finalized. It's already done, it's over, it's already over. It's already over. And just full stop in the wow of that. It's already over. So a definite difference, huge difference between those who are practicing this way and those who are not, obviously. Because it's completely different, isn't it? There's no longer, well, how? No, I've already finished. It's already completed. I'm already done. It's already over. It's already over. And that's all we're practicing. It's already over. And just full stop in the wow of that. This is the practice. It's already over. It's already finished. I've already succeeded. Prior to this private practice, you have the full stop in the wow practice, which is to practice sitting quietly. That's why I said sitting quietly, practicing full stop in the wow is super important practice. And then this has led now to being able to practice that I've already finished with practice. I'm already done. The practice of I'm already done with practice is what it is. And we're able to just full stop, sit quietly, full stop in this. Wow, doesn't bother us at all. So this practice is a grace of God. It was a response to my prayer, desperate prayer. Like we need help now. We need a big boost right now, and the response came from Spirit saying, "Why don't you say I'm already enlightened?" I said, "Huh? I thought I was trying to get to be enlightened. So just say I'm already enlightened." And then I found something in Journey Beyond Words that Jesus said, "Just try imagining that you're already." Perfect and joyful. You're already this way. Imagine how it feels that as if you're already that way. So this is the little leap of faith, he calls it. So there's no question. This is already it. I'm already it. I'm already done. I've already finished. It's already over. It's already complete. This is the practice for these times. Granted, encouragement is helpful, right? Would be helpful. I just trust in Jesus, the Holy Spirit, and the work I've done. I just trust in it enough to try this, because it seems like almost blasphemous. You know, like, what do you mean? You have to do all this work. You've got to get there. What do you mean you're already there? Well, look, if there's no pit, there is no way you get out of the pit at all. You've just been hallucinating a bit. You've never been in there in the first place. So you can't say how I got out of there. You just say I'm already out. I'm already safe. It's already done. It's already been completed. You know, this is... It's already over. It's already finished. I'm already it. Conceptually, what's happening, just full stop in the wow, don't worry. Obviously, there's just like this wow. But if you can just full stop that in the wow, just take it as a wow. Don't worry about whatever leverage and churning is taking place. Just say this wow. This is tremendous. It's already tremendous. I'm already finished. It's already over. It's already completely over. Just sit in the wow. This is the practice that is working so well. So I've been working on this one for about now a couple weeks, and starting to pick up some momentum here. And what's happened the last couple weeks is just occasionally I'll just say, hey, wait a minute, I'm already enlightened. And during the daytime, it'll just sort of occur to me, wait. And so it is really choppy, you know, bit by bit by bit. Sort of get used to using it a little bit more and more and more and more. That's how it goes. It's ragged. It's not some smooth takeoff. It's ragged. I'm obsessing about something, thinking, say, wait a minute, I'm already enlightened. I don't have to even think about this at all. What do I need to think about this? I'm already enlightened, which means these issues don't arise for me at all because I'm already enlightened. When you're enlightened, none of this bother arises at all. None of these questions arise at all. So why am I entertaining these questions? It's ridiculous. I'm already enlightened. Okay, when we're enlightened, none of this concern and problems and bother and questions arise for us at all. And what about someone else's questions? Well, they're the same situation. Just tell them that when you're enlightened, none of these questions will arise for you. The same with everyone else. So just push those questions away. Say, I'm already enlightened. Therefore, these questions have nothing to do with me. Well, nothing to do with me whatsoever. These concerns, these obsessions, these troubles have nothing to do with me whatsoever. I'm already enlightened. They are not arising for me at all. They don't arise. They just drop it. Your health, bad health. I'm already perfectly well. I'm already perfect. This notion of health, bad health, and problems is ridiculous. I'm already perfect. What relevance does that have to me whatsoever? None. Enlightened, the issues of ill health, etc., don't even arise at all. Jesus says, all we have to do is stop our thinking. Well, this is how we stop our thinking, right? I'm already enlightened. There's nothing I need to think about. So whatever we find is bothersome for us right now, just say I'm already enlightened. Therefore, none of this stuff is bothersome whatsoever. It doesn't even arise for me. I don't even need to think about it in the slightest bit. I'm already enlightened. I'm already seamlessly blissful. I'm already seamlessly untroubled. I'm already seamlessly untroubled. So what does talk about seams have to do with me? I'm already seamless. Since I'm already seamless, there's no issue of seams at all. No need to think about seams at all. I don't have any seams. I'm seamless. There's no, how did I get rid of seams? I've never had any seams. I'm seamless. I'm already seamless. I'm already untroubled. I'm already trouble-free. I'm already trouble-free. I'm already seamless. I already left my troubles behind. I already left all troubles behind. So, very auspicious video. This is where we're getting into the practice here. This is the practice, 215. Starting 215, this is the practice now. This is where we're at. Which is, I'm already finished my practicing. I already left all my troubles behind. I already left all troubles behind. I'm already seamless. I'm already seamlessly happy. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. I'm already thought free. Already enlightened. I already left all troubles behind. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. I'm already perfect. I'm already complete. Abiding in the non-dual. Already abiding in the oneness. Already free of the body, already free of the world, already free of time-space, I'm already free of process, already free of delusion, I'm already free of delusion. So if you've been on the spiritual path long enough, you know how it goes. You crawl before you can walk, and so you have to be humble enough to start out simple. It's a path of humility, repentance, humility. Say, I have a severe continuity problem. I know as I try to do what's right, I'm going to suffer. I'm going to seem to be stumbling a bit. It's not going to be easy for me. I have a different struggle with it because of the enormous continuity. If you're like, oh, I don't, you know, maybe I'll be too successful. But no, I've already succeeded. I've already succeeded. So again, as I see, working through this, I see. It takes a while to get rolling. It's like pushing a car that's been sitting there with deflated tires. It's hard to get it going. Once you get it going, then you can keep it going, and then eventually you get some momentum and you can get it going faster and faster. So don't be discouraged by feeble efforts. This is the key. And this is what I've been able to work through is that at first my efforts have been feeble. And I keep thinking, oh, is this going to work? I don't know. Can I? Just feeble. So at first your efforts will be feeble. But put up with a couple of days, weeks, even months of feeble effort, whatever it takes. And someday there'll be a point where you'll say, you know, I want to try this a little more. And then you start working at it and you realize, hey, I can do this. And then you get start getting better and better at it. It's like anything. You may start out feeble, but with it. One that you feel comfortable with, which I picked, just say, I am already enlightened. I'm already enlightened. So whatever is arising for you, you say, it's not arising for me at all. I'm already enlightened. This does not arise for me as enlightened. In the enlightened edition, none of this arises like this at all. So I don't need to engage with any of this nonsense. It's just utter nonsense. I don't even have any nonsense. I already am free of all nonsense. I'm already free of all nonsense. And so you don't even think about it anymore. Your thinking stops in regard to everything that's happening, all this nonsense. Yes, I'm already free of all nonsense. I'm already enlightened. So this does not, there's no thinking about any of this. It doesn't even arise for me. You might call it, you know, supreme detachment. This is a practice in supreme detachment. That's one way of putting it, but I wouldn't necessarily put it that way, but you know, some could say that. But I'm already. It's not like you're detached from the dream, but you practice detaching, and you're like, I'm already awake. It's not that I'm dreaming, but I'm detached from it. I'm already awake. I'm already perfectly detached. I'm already perfectly unaffected. Beyond that, I'm already enlightened. This stuff, I'm not bothered. There isn't anything bothering me. In other words, there's nothing bothering me at all. I'm seamlessly satisfied. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. And sort of allow yourself to imagine how that feels a little bit. You know, very feeble. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. I'm already eternal life. I'm already eternal life. I am already the eternal life of seamless satisfaction. I am already that. I am already that. Again, you either do it or you don't. It's simple. You see, just keep it simple. Keep it simple. Very simple. You either do practice this way or you don't. Obviously, you can never compensate by process kind of practicing for this type of practicing. there's no way to compensate for it, because we're saying, I've already finished. I'm already done. I'm already through. I'm already awake. How do you compensate for that by saying, well, I'm working towards being awake, and you cannot. There's a gap there, isn't there? You can never bridge that gap through process, because we're saying, no, I'm already here. I'm already finished. Full stop. In the wow, I'm already done. And we're practicing this way. I'm already done. There's already nothing I need to do. I already don't need do nothing. I already need do nothing. I already need do nothing. So we either practice this way or we don't. It's very simple. So why not go for it? Why not do it? Why not go for it? Why not say, I'm already done. I already need do nothing. I am already seamlessly satisfied. I'm already done. I'm already finished. I already need do nothing. Left. I don't have leaving on my mind. I've already left. It's already completed. It's already done. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. I'm already the eternal life of seamless satisfaction. I am already that eternal life of seamless satisfaction. I am already that. I am already that. I am already that. If you start projecting in the future, say, no, I'm already finished with time. I'm already timeless. I'm already enlightened. None of that need be considered at all. I'm already there. I'm already here. I'm already here. I'm already home. I'm already in the totality. I'm already seamlessly satisfied. Just keep practicing as much as possible. This is a transition. As you try to practice in other ways, just say, no, I've already finished practicing. I'm done. I'm already finished. I'm already enlightened. Stay with the wow of this. You know, just when you feel like not saying anything, you just stay in the wow of this situation. This is very wowful practicing to say, I've already finished practicing. done. I'm finished. I've already finished. I've already finished. Already thought free. Already time free, already the timeless one. I'm already the timeless one. I am already the timeless one. Dig for results. Don't look for results. Just keep practicing. Say, I already have the results. Results? I already have the results. I already have all the results. I already have all the results. I've already crossed the bridge. I already have all the results. I'm already on the other side. I'm already safe. See, dreams are never completed because they give rise to guilt, which causes the dreaming to continue on. You never get to the other side. You struggle, you can't quite get out, and you know, there's always more to the dream. So you cannot end the dream by succeeding within the dream. You have to say, I'm already on the other side. Like you're trying to cross a river. You just say, I'm already here. I'm already on the other side. It's already finished. It's already done. Done doesn't make any difference. I'm already here. I'm already here. It's already done. It's already complete. There's already no struggle. I'm already untroubled. I'm already awake. I'm already enlightened. Can someone who is struggling, can they get this? Like, certainly they can feel as if this might be the answer. I'm trying to look back at my own life path here. Long ago, thinking, could I have looked at this and said, yeah, that might work? I would say yes. I would have read it and I would have considered it and said, I would certainly feel like, you know, there's probably some, you know, there's probably truth to this. I just not sure. Can I do it? I don't know. But yeah, you can feel like that. Hey, maybe this is it. This is already it. practice, we say, this is already it. I've already got it. I remember a dream I had long ago where I came into this world, like sort of a park, like I represented this world, and I had this golden ring, and as I stepped into this world, somehow it seemed I fumbled the ring. Somehow I dropped it. I don't know how I dropped it. And I heard a clink, 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 clink. And I said, oh my gosh, the ring is hit and rolled somewhere. Where is it? And I started looking for it, and I couldn't find it. I've been looking for it ever since. And so the answer is to say, I already have it. Stop the search. You see, I already have it. I already found it. I already have it. It's already with me. Because did I ever lose it? No. I simply hallucinated that I lost it. So assert that, no, I already have it. I already have it. Realizing that the hallucination can't see that, obviously. When we think about hallucinating, if we're hallucinating something, we can also hallucinate not seeing something that's there. I already have everything. I'm already not missing anything. So it doesn't matter what a hallucination does or doesn't. It doesn't matter. I'm already finished with hallucinations. I'm already free of hallucinations. No body, no world, no guilt. I'm already free. I'm already timeless. So just keep practicing. This is how I practice. You just keep doing it. Just keep doing it. Like a shoot around at basketball. You know, you keep looking for a basketball, then you get one and you shoot it. Look for another one and you shoot it. Keep shooting. Keep working out. I already can't miss. I'm already a sure thing. I already have nothing to prove. I already have nothing to prove. I already need do nothing. I already have nothing to prove. I already have nothing to find. Now people are going everywhere in California today. It's like 80 degrees in a lot of places. Just this like a summer day. But we're here doing something, you know, truly wonderful, which is to say I've already finished. I'm already abiding in the eternal life of seamless satisfaction. I already need not go anywhere or do anything. I'm already perfect. I'm already flawless. I've already finished. It's all already over. All troubles are already over. I already left all troubles behind. I already left all concerns behind. I've already left all fear behind. I've already left all doubt behind. I've already left all concern behind. So, everybody's going somewhere in California. We're leaving everything behind. It's already been left behind. It's already gone. All troubles are already gone. How about that? And we're just sitting here quietly. I'm already everywhere. I'm already free of death. I'm already death free. I'm already death free. See? Almost didn't get that one in there, right? Because that's the one that everybody says, no, you got it. You can't do that. Yes, we can. I'm already death free. I'm already free of death. I'm already completely free of death. Enlightened. I'm already the enlightened one. I'm already the enlightened oneness. I'm already the shared enlightenment. Don't look for results, just keep practicing. I'm already totally in the zone. I'm already totally aware. I'm already free of all limitations. I'm already untroubled. Some time to catch your breath. This is very intense practice, so we're not trying to prove anything. Everything's already been proven. Everything's already been proven. All answers have already been given. Everything has already been proven. I'm already seamlessly satisfied and blissful. I'm already tranquil. I'm already still. I'm already calm. I'm already peaceful. Everything has already been proven. Everything's already been answered. All answers have already been given. All proof has already been supplied. All evidence has already been seen, given. I'm already in the visionary state. I'm already in the vision of oneness. So this is super interesting to practice this and get to recognize the results. And of course, they say, I already have all the results. This is the practice. I already have all the results. I already have everything that I was looking for. I already have all the results. Without any exception, it's already complete, absolutely complete. It's already absolutely complete. Not a single exception to that whatsoever. It's already totally, perfectly complete. Totally, perfectly complete. Completed, done, finished, over. All the results are in. Nothing left. Nothing left to do. I don't need to do anything. I already don't need to do nothing. Perfectly well. And already, I'm already enlightened. I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened. Okay, so that's pushing things about as much as I can push them right at the moment. I'm going to let this sink in for me, as this has been the first time I've been able to do this intensely. Share it with the cosmos verbally this way. And so this has been a big push for me. But it's done. Wonderful. Very great. Okay, so just remember the wow of this situation is already, I'm already have the wow. Or we could say, I'm already done with the wow. It's already settled in. It's all done. It's all finished. It's all perfect. It's all complete. I'm already totally worthy. I'm already totally worthy. Already totally experiencing the oneness. I'm already totally experiencing the sublime, seamless satisfaction. I'm already experiencing the sublime, seamless satisfaction. I'm already experiencing this. Okay, without any further ado, let's end this video.